factor. And I searched and found that curve, which is very typical curve, and which is also called forgetting curve. It's a memory with a time. So your memory can be lost within the time if it is not boosted in between frequently. So there is also a formula given by in 1885 by Hermann Ebbinghaus. And that is also taking that memory as a motivation, and the time factor is there. So how I have just remodeled that formula, where M is the motivation for self-sustaining, and F is the frequency of that collaborative learning, and T is the time factor. So with this, how frequently that motivation is needed within that given time frame. If we take too much time and too much of frequency of that motivation, it will end up somewhere saturation. So there should be some kind of optimum duration and frequency for higher motivation. And it should not be very frequent motivation, and should not be very long time taking. So within that time frame, which is very optimal, we have to have some kind of motivational factor so that the effectiveness will be higher. And so, but there is something missing in between, is that M is equal to exponential to the power minus T by F. Maybe some other factor is also influencing that motivation. It's not that only you have some boosted motivation all the time, but people are also, it's natural that they are already highly motivated and they need frequently motivation. Or they have smaller motivation already and they need higher motivation. That is a parameter is missing there. And that parameter probably I added with the alpha. It could be exponential or another one. You have already a motivation at a certain point of time and then that starts decreasing, and that decreasing point, and then you need a pulse for the motivation. And the sum of at end of the motivation, when you have that encouragement or inspiration, that might be very costly. So the small impulse that might be increasing your motivation would be less costly. So that is the point I want to bring. Then all the time, our activities should be in a kind of a perpetuality, the will, perpetual will, which needs to be in a turn round and round and increasing or providing the impact. And that is I call perpetual will of collaboration. Small exchange or curriculum, there are small states, but there that must be turned very fast so that either in that way, that must be turned very fast so that we have collaborative large will be initiated. And that collaborative large will, if it is even turned smaller state, that will bring the larger impact on education and curriculum development. So that everything is dependent. So who is turning what? And then motivation could be by exchanging, by visiting the nano world. I have visited Professor Loss's laboratory here. It is completely different world for me, which is micro nano world. You cannot visualize with the eyes. You have to have an instrument to visualize that one. And you need a photon to energize that one and visualize. So a very nice picture of many things inside the human body. You can visualize. And also the macro world where you can see with your naked eyes also bigger machines, inspiring, running. You can hear them also. You can talk to people. And there are professors very encouraged to show their laboratories, even allowing us to take the photographs. It is not secret here. Okay, so these are the things also needed to understand. And also meeting people,
Mm-hmm.
It's not only looking at the machines or very basic fundamental research, but also talking to people, seeing places, and celebrating free time.
Mm-hmm.
All have one triangular pattern, that is, you build a relationship, get energized, and you act for something, bringing more impact on the society. And that goes on in triangular pattern. And that is for sustainable development of your own country. So there are a few points I have brought here for, you know, prospect for collaboration between EPFL and KU. Small step, I already mentioned, exchange of students, faculty, and staff. We have already started doing that one. Joint research activities, we are trying to do that one also in future. You know, participation in seminar or academic meetings, like this is also one of the, in this series, I consider it the largest we have done here. Exchange of academic materials, when you visit each other's places, you have also materials exchange or information exchange. We can go for the short-term academic or summer schools or winter schools, like staff development by bringing them here, get a training, and then other